First up tonight are our sixth graders. Everything about tonight is more relaxed, the music, more fun, lighter. We're just gonna have a good time. Sixth graders are performing selections from Princess and the Frog, complete with choreography that I did not do. So if you don't like it, please address any complaints to Miss Diane Vanneman. She's seventh grade math teacher. Okay? Who had her own studio for 30 years, so I think she knows what she's doing. But we're gonna have fun. I need to show off some posters. I wanted to have these out front, but we don't have any easels. And since they're done by a student, I can't just let them sit up here and not be seen. So I'm going to show you. All right, so we have Princess and the Frog. Yay. Okay. Calm down. All right. All of my posters were done by one of our seventh grade students, Bailey Levy, who you will see her next. Woo! And with only slight, and I emphasize only slight touch-ups by Miss Hammer, our art teacher. So, and I mean that. Bailey did it all. Miss Hammer just went back and did some. So that will forever hang in the choir room unless she says no and wants to take it home with her. Then I have to let her. Okay. Sixth grade, stand up. We have several soloists in this first group. They are listed on your program. I would try and name them, but I don't have the program in front of me and I don't want to leave somebody off. So you take care of that for me. Hold the applause to the end. Each medley is about anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes long. This one, I think, is right at 10 minutes long. So just sit back and enjoy Princess and the Frog.
There's no know I've had my share.
Money ain't got no soul, money ain't got no heart.
Not bad. Not bad. Okay. Okay, real quick. Now we have Joseph in the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. If you are not familiar with it, it's a very cute musical. So you're going to hear a musical from the beginning of Andrew Lloyd Webber's career, which was this one, and then one from much later in his career with the eighth graders with Phantom of the Opera. And you're going to think they're not possibly written by the same guy, but they are. A little bit of history on this. Yes, it tells the story of Joseph from the Old Testament. But he does it through a variety of different songs. So you're going to hear kind of 60s pop songs, kind of 70s pop songs. There's calypso, there's country and western. Of course, there's no standing still, but it's a very cute show. I needed some help on the choreography. Some of it I did. I shouldn't call it choreography. It's more like, I don't know. Just put your hand up at this time. Some of it is done by Rachel. Rachel, wave. And some of it is done by Miss Groover, which many of you know. So all the really good stuff Rachel did, all the sort of kind of cute stuff Miss Groover did, the dynamic things that just blow your mind, that was me. So, okay, parents, cross your fingers. This should be fun. We've got lots of solos. Again, you've got them in front of you because I would hate to leave somebody off trying to remember off the top of my head. Ooh. That was close. Okay, are you ready? There is a reason for the banana costume. I promise. Jack has outstanding fashion sense, but this one's my fault. All right? All right, good luck.
When you say back, you can't treat the show.
of the river came about and then now I need a fine, healthy aunt and 7 other cows out to any. Then cows ain't the bad cows, would you not? Oh, yeah. But it didn't make it better like a supper really should. Oh, yeah. And cows were as thin as they had ever, ever been. About Joseph, won't you tell me what it means?
Thank you.
Told you I did a good job with the choreography. Good job, Rachel. Thank you, Rachel. Bailey. Here's our artiste for the night. Here's Bailey. Okay, seventh grade. Same thing with the sixth grade. You know Mr. Hawkins. So we're going to go off a road of time, and you all can sit along that wall. Don't bother these parents. They didn't pay to hear you talk. Okay? Good job. So, road of time. Abby, lead us off. Okay, the Phantom of the Opera, yay. My second favorite musical. I'm still a Les Mis fan, but oh well. And if you are thoroughly impressed by tonight, which you will be, Phantom's coming to Nashville in March. So, probably need to get your tickets now, because they're probably getting close to selling out already. It'll be here for 2 weeks, 10 days or 2 weeks, I think. Last time it came to Nashville, they had to give it an extra week because there was such demand. So, if you don't know anything about Phantom, this is a great introduction. This was my introduction to Phantom when I was in high school. We actually did the same medley when I was in high school. And so then I wanted to go see Phantom because I'd never seen it before. But I am a big Phantom fan. I've seen it a few times. I would love to go back in March. And I haven't done this one in a while because I've not had a group that could do it. I've got a group that can do it, and they can really, really do a good job, especially when they focus and they concentrate. What's the number one thing we're thinking about when we're singing English? Pronunciation, vowels. Okay. One of the first things we learn in choir is that the hardest language to sing in is English because of all of our different dialects and the way we pronounce things. And man, has it been evident working on this. We have probably worked more on pronunciation than anything else. Okay? I'm excited for them. If they do the way that they have done during rehearsals, I think you're going to like it. Before we start that, though, I want to recognize some people because I will forget, because I always do. First of all, Victory Baptist Church. Let's give them a round of applause, please. Maddie, what's your mom's name? Deanna? I would also like to thank Miss Deanna Smith. Most of the roses that you see up here, she got them for us, and she just showed up and said, here. Actually, she gave them to Maddie and said, here, for any of the girls that don't have roses. So, Miss Smith, wherever you are, thank you so much for that. And I would also like to introduce my student teacher that I have. Caleb, come up here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Caleb Hawkins, the now graduate of MTSU. He has he's got his music ed degree and Spanish, and his Spanish degree. He also is a fine piano player, so he's got it. He's got everything except a job. Which he has been working at and working at and working at. And let me tell you, when he gets a job, because he will, his students are in for a fine teacher. He has done an outstanding job. I've had a student teacher before, and it was awful. I had to sit him down and say, it's not happening. But not with Caleb. Mr. Hawkins just jumped in, took the initiative, hey, can I have class tomorrow, this time? Sure, heck yeah, you can. And I trusted him, okay? I trusted him because we have to have a lot of trust. You know, this is my choir. I've been working with them for a while, and to hand somebody else my choir and say, sure, go for it. I have to trust them because they can't mess up the way my choir sounds. And he hasn't. He has done a really good job. So his last day was actually Wednesday, but he, you know, he's put in a ton of work. So he said, I'll be there Monday. He's been here all day. As you can see, we're both dressed exactly alike tonight. It did not matter what we wore. The kids always, if they see a man in a dress shirt and a tie and slacks, you're dressed exactly alike. You're twins today. Okay. He's also a huge Beethoven fan. Okay. So I have something that's mine, but you know what? I'm done with it. I've looked at it 1,000 times. I've read everything there is to read on it. So if you stand right there, I'll be right back. All right, this was given to me a long time ago, and it's an old book to begin with because it's the bicentennial edition of Beethoven. So 1970, and it was actually given to someone else before it was given to me. So there's an inscription in there from someone else to someone else before I got it, and now there's an inscription from me to you, which I can't open because Mrs. Clark, she's still recovering, so let's leave it like this for a little while. Okay, so you take this. It's been a pleasure. Oh, we're hugging. All right. All right, he's a good guy. Okay, eighth grade parents, this is where I have to say goodbye to you. This is our last time. Now, let me tell you what a pleasure it is. And Caleb can tell you, he's been other schools, he's heard other choirs, and ours is just, they're on a different level. I've been able to do more with this eighth grade group and quicker than any group I've ever had. And I've had incredibly talented groups. And I have sent incredibly talented singers to high school, and we have sent incredibly talented singers on to college. But from top to bottom, this group, with the solos, I was telling the mother earlier, really, I could have just drawn names out of a hat because everybody that tried just did a fantastic job. And the difference between the ones that got solos and one that didn't is like one note. Could they hit one note better than the other person? And that's a blessing. That's a good problem to have. So I hope they brought their good singing voices with them tonight. Have fun. You don't have to do it again. Okay?
Yeah.
think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me once in a while, please promise me you'll try. When you find that once again you long to take a hold back and be free.
Think of me waking silent and resigned. Imagine me trying to haunt you, put you from my mind.
Recall those days, look back on all those times. Think of the things we'll never do. There will never be.
Thank you. That's all I ask of you.
Okay. Couple of things. Sixth and seventh grade auditions for Black and Gold next year will be at the beginning of next year. So I'll send music home. Very soon to be freshman parents. They're messing with the schedules of high school. So just bear with them. They're working on it. But there are a lot of options for choir. Okay, by default, freshmen go into beginner's choir. And that's just how they have to do it. So they'll be in there with other freshmen and then all of the other upperclassmen that have to have the credit. But it doesn't matter. They still get a superior at festival. If you can't do that, you've got two extracurricular options. You've got LOVE, which is the Ladies of Vocal Excellence, the women's only group. Very hard to get into as a freshman, but not impossible. But if you go into it knowing that it's hard to get into, then it's you understand if you don't get in. There's also MOVE for the boys, Men of Vocal Excellence. Again, those are things that if you can't get choir into your schedule, they are after school. They're extracurricular. You can still do it. Okay? So be thinking about that. Because those are all things, parents, when you start talking about college and scholarships, those are things that you'd like to see on that resume that can maybe get you a music scholarship, even if you don't want to be a music teacher. You know? I was a sports medicine major. Who also had a vocal scholarship, okay? Then I got my mind right and went to music education. Eighth grade parents, it has been wonderful. It really has. I was gonna go and interview for the Wilson Central High School position. But I've had too many people say, yeah, I don't know if you want to do that. But so I'll be around at least another semester. We'll see. But parents, I appreciate it. Kids, I appreciate it. Okay? You get on my nerves, but I love you. Real quick, while I have black and gold in here, you got to sing for the fifth graders tomorrow, Wednesday, and Thursday. A song. Okay? Thank you, parents. I'll see you later.